I thought in this video I'd show you how to replace the speakers in your back deck. And I also have an unfortunate update for all of you. We got a nasty hailstorm that came through, and a softball sized piece of hail came and just destroyed that back window. So that's why I've got that glorified trash bag on it. Anyway, step one on how to get those out is you got to remove your back seat. Now, mine's clips are broke, but there should be little clips right down here. You pull one here. Be careful about this. There's busted glass in there. And there's another one down here. So you pull on those. And then you pull the seat up. Slide in here. Yeah, you pull those up. And then you pull out the back seat. Alright, now that you got your back seat out, now there are a few bolts you're going to have to take loose. You got one here, you got one over there. Those are both, I think they're 18, but 3/4 is as close as I can get. And then you got these two guys. You got one here, you got one over there. You get those out. Then you're going to have to be patient about this, but you're going to have to pull up on this on all both sides and in the middle. And in the middle over there. And take this out. Now that you've got all those out, you got this seat pulled loose. Now you need to try to pick it up. See if you can't get it loose. This is not easy to do one. So let me give this a shot. Oh, that's not loose. Ouch. I'm gonna have to keep fighting with that, guys. Okay. I got that seat loose, and it's ready to come out. These are what you're trying to pull loose. There's one over there. Out of here, 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 and over there. You get those loose, pull that out, and put it on the bottom part of the seat. And now that you got your back seat completely out, now you gotta take this off. It's gonna require you to pull these clips out. You should be able to get your finger under there and pull it out. And you're also gonna have to take your seat belt out, which that's not hard to do. You just do it like that on both sides. And you pull it out. And I would go put it with your back seat so you don't lose it. Now that you got this off, now you gotta get these speakers out. This is a 1/4-inch socket. I'd recommend you use a socket instead of a wrench. It's just easier to deal with. But it's not that hard to get out. You put that on there and you just loosen this off. And I know I should be using a ratchet, but this is all I could find in this drive size. You take all these out. I got one here, I got one, and I got one back here. There should be one here and here, but I lost the screws for it. And it's the same case with this speaker over here. But you get those screws out and then I'll show you what to do. Okay, now that you got all the screws out, it's a matter of pulling the speaker up and out. I'm messing with this one because the wires came loose on the bottom. Here are the wires. But yeah, when you try to pull yours out, if the wires are still hooked up, they're not going to come out nearly, it's not coming out anywhere near that easy. And if you're putting aftermarket back in, you might as well just clip the factory wires and splice in the ones that came with your aftermarket speaker. This is a Skosh HD speaker, 6x9. Absolutely love the way these things sound for El Cheapo speakers. 450-watt 6x9 speaker. After you've spliced in the aftermarket speaker wires into your factory wiring, You want to connect this, the smallest connector to the smallest one on here. Push your insulator up over it to try to protect it. Oh, piece of shit. Alright. Correction, this has to be flat or it won't go on there far enough. And then I should have a connector on here, but I don't, so I'm just gonna have to stick it straight into here. And then you lower your new speaker down into place. And then you put your bolts in. At the moment, you're not looking to get these just super, super tight. You just wanna get them in so you can get it all lined up. Anyway, you're gonna have to play with the alignment just a little bit to get as many of these in as you can. That's why I don't want to tighten these down all the way. Okay, now that you've got those in and wired up, now comes the fun part. Now you get to test them. Go back to the first song. I like that one. Put it back together. All right, first step in reassembly, take this back deck cover and put it back in. It's not that hard to reinstall. You put the back up there, you push these clips back in, put your seatbelt back through, then you do the same on the other side. All right, scratch that, I don't seem to have a clip anymore. But you still pull your seatbelt through, push it back tight. Then you gotta put your seat back in. All right, sorry guys. I wanted to show you how to get that in, but once you get that lined up, it usually just kind of falls right in. The next step after you do that is to put your seat belts back in. Yeah. It's my amp wire. Just in case you were wondering what that big wire is. You get that in there, then you put your bolts back in. These big bolts, you want to get them really tight because they're what's anchoring the people in the back seat. If you have to stop quickly, so you really don't want those to come loose. I'm sure there's a torque spec somewhere that tells you exactly how tight to get this, but I don't know what that is offhand. You want to get these as tight as you can hope to get them. If you really don't want these coming loose, going down the road. Yeah, that one ain't going no tighter. Now for the other side. Anyway, I'm not gonna make you watch me tighten those down. You get those two middle ones, that one there, and that one as tight as you can absolutely get it. And then these smaller ones go on here. They go on right there. And these you do want to get tight. But it's not as critical as far as how tight you get them. I'm just gonna make these finger tight so that they don't come off. All these do is help secure that back seat. They're not really holding any people in. You do the same thing on that other side over there. Alright, once you got the back in, now you need to put your seat in. I've already got it loosely laid in place. What you need to remember to do is to pull the seatbelt locks up so people can actually use their seatbelts. But you get that down in there, and then you should just be able to push straight down on each side and the seat lock in. But yeah, do that, and congrats, you just changed out your rear speakers.